Welcome. This is another video on the lecture series called Electromagnetic Theory. In this video, I am going to explain the concept of vector field and types of vector field. You know that vector is a quantity which has magnitude and direction, and we represent that vector by an arrow. This is the vector. So vector field is the made up of the many vector at each point. So this is the example of a representation of the vector field where each point has a field which has both direction and magnitude. So this is the vector field, just like electric field is the vector field. So this is the vector field, and each point of space has value. Suppose V x y z is the vector field. It means this vector field has some component along the I j k axis, I j k, or along the x y z coordinate system. So Vx, Vy and Vz is the three component of the vector field Vx, Yz at the point P. So this is the vector field, and vector field is the important concept of electromagnetic theory, because after all, in electromagnetic theory, any kind of electric field or magnetic field is actually a vector field. So we have to understand this idea of vector field. We have many types of vector field. This one is the vector field which has the same direction. It means it has the same direction. This vector field is diverging at or converging at one point P. This is the vector field which is meeting at the one point P. This one is the vector field which is changing the direction. It means it is circulating vector field, and this is actually called curl, and this is divergence. This vector field or magnetic field also an example of circulating vector field, where each point has different direction. So it is the circulating or changing vector field, and magnetic field is also a vector field. So these are the some example of the type of vector field. Now, principle of superposition is the important idea in the electromagnetic theory. This principle of superposition says that electric field at a point, any point P, due to multiple charges, equal to the sum of electric field due to each charges. Suppose this is a point P, and these are Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6, and many charges are some specific distance away from P. Then at P, there is a electric field from each charge. So total electric field is the sum of each electric field. So E1 is the electric field due to Q1, E2 is the electric field due to Q2, E3 is the electric field due to Q3, and E4 is the electric field due to Q4. So net electric field EP is equal to E1 plus E2 plus E3 ...EN. So EN. EI and I equal to 1 to N. So sum of each electric field. This is the principle of superposition. Why? Because electromagnetic theory is the linear theory. It is the linear theory in which solution of one, solution of two of the same function f, and if we combine this solution, this combination of this solution will also be the solution of this function. So this is the principle of superposition. Now we have a problem called total electric field due to three charges. Suppose there are three charges P, Q and S. P has charge minus Q, Q has charge plus Q and S has charge plus Q. And we have to calculate electric field at P due to these three charges. We take Q, this one charge, as the origin, and X and Y are the coordinate, and this O is the origin. So we have to calculate the electric field. Electric field at P, total electric at P is equal to sum of individual electric field E1P, E2P, E3P, KQ1, R1P square, R1P, these are the unit vector, and we have to calculate R1P, R2P, R3P, R3P. From the distance of origin, from the distance of Q3 from the origin is A by 2, and this one is also A by 2. So P and S are equal distance from the origin O. It means the Y coordinate of the this one is Y minus and this one is X. So R3P can be written as XI plus Y minus 2, and R2P can be written as X plus Y, and this one R1P can be written XI plus Y plus A by 2. So this one, it means we have this as the component form. So R3P square is equal to X square plus Y minus 2 whole square, R2P square is equal to X square plus Y square, and R1P square is equal to X square plus Y plus A by 2 whole square. And we have to put this into this one. Also, this R3P can be written as cos theta I plus sin theta j y. Suppose this is the angle theta. It means it has one component, and cos theta is what you call x divided by r 3 plus y minus a divided by r 3. This one is the R3P. It means R3P square is equal to X square plus Y minus 2 whole square. So we have to put this one, and we will get this one as the electric field due to these three charges at point P. So this is the total electric field due to three charges, PQ and